Nook Inc. Deserted Island Getaway Package. Yes! I'm excited to get away. And I also like packages. Hi, Timmy. Good morning. We're so excited to have you here. Let us be the first to congratulate you on your wise decision to sign up for this adventure. Welcome to the check-in counter. The first step on any good adventure starts at the check-in counter. Your deserted getaway island package. There's so much to look forward to, like deserts. But first, let me introduce ourselves. Let me introduce ourselves. Let us introduce ourselves. I'm Timmy with Nook Inc. And I'm Tommy. We'll be flying to the island with you to help you get settled. Oh my gosh, on Dodo Airlines? Do I get to fly Dodo Airlines? Oh my god. Think of us as your partners. We're in it for the long haul. So let's get started, shall we? I actually really love Dodo Airlines. I like it so much that I ended up doing a Banjo-Billy episode of building a Dodo Airlines airplane, which you can see tomorrow on this channel. Make sure you're subscribed and click that bell. Cool, let's go. Let's get started. Now then, we'll need to look up your application. Can we have your name and birthday? Yeah, my name is... What? My name is... Who? My name is... Wooka wooka. Josh Jepson. I'm gonna go with Jepson. This is my preferred name for everyone to call me across the internets, in general social spaces. This is the name that I go by. I am perfectly okay with Jepson. My birthday. Oh, hey, you know what? My birthday's coming up. Not really. It's actually not until June 3rd. Jepson, let's see. Oh, yes, here you are. Our next step will be to take a picture of you, Jepson. Oh, don't worry. Take as much time as you need to get yourself looking the way you want. I actually do play as females in video games quite a lot. So it wouldn't be unheard of for me to play as a female in Animal Crossing New Horizons at some point. Oh, no, that's the one right there, right? I'm pale. Pale AF. Oh my god. this is the EGAD mouth. I want to be adorable. Is that okay? Am I allowed to be adorable? Yes! The blush! I've elected not to do rosy cheeks. I've changed my mind about the rosy cheeks. Here we go. Yeah, that looks great. Great, you're all set. I'll just go ahead and add that picture to our records. And now, let's start talking about your new home. Oh my gosh. Wait, so I get the deserted island getaway package and I get a new house? That's crazy. I wonder how much this is... I wonder how much all of this is going to cost. Perhaps I'll have to take out a loan. You see, we're quite proud of the work we've done to help you feel comfortable in your new life. In fact, if you want, you can even experience the seasons the same way you're used to them. What I mean is, we have islands in both the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere. We recommend choosing an island that has the same seasonal pattern as your current home. So tell me, Jepson, where do you live now? I live in North America. So, that's the Northern Hemisphere, y'all. Just saying. Which is cool that they have the Southern Hemisphere up in this piece. There are a few more decisions to make, but does that sound okay to you so far? Yep, sounds good to me. Very good. We have a number of lovely inhabited islands. Uninhabited? I should hope so. I want a completely uninhabited island. I want to go sit there in the middle of the island by myself and play. That's how I'm going to play the game for the whole time. We have a number of lovely uninhabited islands in the Northern Hemisphere to choose from. Now then, all of our islands are approximately the same size, and they're all quite natural. So don't worry about whether or not you'll have enough space or comfort. Comfort? There's going to get a little of that mana coming out in me, you know, because I'm up from, I'm from the Northeast, originally. I'm from the Northeast up there. Anyway, you can't go wrong. Just follow your instincts and choose an island with a layout that looks appealing. That's how I'd do it. I'll show you some maps now, and you can choose the best one for your new home. Oh, guys, okay, so here, well, I'll take a moment here to sort of give you a general idea of what I want to do with my island. So, first of all, I want to say welcome to Tanooki Island. It's Tanooki Island. The lore is that Tanooki Town is being built on Tanooki Island, and we're gonna pick the general shape of our island right now. I kind of like this actually, but then I also like this. And also, it doesn't matter too much because I can edit a lot of this later. Oh, this is kind of neat though, to have like the rivers flow down from the hills. I kind of like that, and then I can build my fortress up in the top left corner. I think I'm gonna go with this one. Yep. This is what we're doing. We're doing it. Ah, but before we depart, I have just one final question for you. If you could only bring one thing with you to a deserted island, what would it be? Ooh. Oh, wait. Hold up. They're gonna let me pick, like, a thing to start with? I kind of like light. Light is good. But honestly, I think something to kill time. Because we're starting during the day, right? So something to kill time would be great. I want to be entertained, man. If I'm going to be stuck on a deserted island for entertainment, I guess, I want to be entertained. Oh, I'm sorry. That was just a hypothetical question. Oh, wow. I feel like I got trolled. Nook Inc. will fully cover all of your basic needs. Yes, yes. Wait a minute. You're going to cover all my basic needs? You're not going to make me pay for it later, are you? There's not hidden fees here, are we? Oh, God. Here we go. Deserted Island Getaway Package is ready for boarding. Let's go. I'm excited to explore Tanooki Island and see what kind of fruit we get. That's our first, like, objective, I guess, is to figure out what fruit we have. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for taking this chartered flight as part of Nook Inc.'s Deserted Island Getaway Package. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy a complimentary video presentation about deserted island life. Ooh. So relaxing. My ultimate goal with this series is going to be to have basically a spot for you guys to come every day to relax and unwind and get away from the world. We're not going to be talking about topics on this show that are a little rough around the edges. We're going to have a lot of fun is what we're going to do. We're going to try to have as much fun as possible and make a lot of laughs and memories and memes together. And I hope that you all join me in Good Morning Tanooki Town. We're going to build. Look, we're going to craft stuff. We're going to catch fish and listen to the dumb fish puns. And we're going to get all the museum items, and we're gonna catch all the bugs, which is part of the museum, so I don't know why that was kind of a redundant thing to say. And it's all gonna be in real time, shot throughout every day. My basic goal with this is gonna be to release videos Monday through Friday, recorded each day. We're here! Oh my god, we're here. We're here. Now I know you must be incredibly excited to explore your new island home, but I have one small request. Would you please join us for a short orientation session in the nearby plaza? Our fearless leader himself will be giving a presentation, so I'd hate for you to miss it. Our fearless leader. Are you talking about Tom Nook? Because, I guess I would describe Tom Nook as a fearless leader. He is quite the entrepreneur. All right, let's heckin' go, dude. Wait, are you guys coming? We gotta follow the guides. All right, let's go. Wait, hang on, but no, you're not coming. What's your name? Sprocket. Talk later, jog now. So I have Sprocket and, wait, what's your name? Hang on, I'm sorry, I didn't see what your name was. Get back here. And Sylvia? Sprocket and Sylvia, wow. First of all, Sprocket is gotta be like one of the most interesting Animal Crossing characters I've ever seen. Are you a robot freaking woodpecker or like roadrunner or whatever you are. He's a robot, dude. I love him. I want to build him like a freaking lab to to like do his evil experiments in. His AI overlord. He's number 4. He's got a 4 on the back of his head. All right, I'm here, Nook. What do you want? Is that everyone? Let's see. Is Sylvia here? Present. Sprocket? Hell yeah, dude. Sprocket's awesome. He's like my new favorite villager of all time. And Jepson's here. He's got the wrong hair, though. Very good. How shall I begin? Of course. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to your new island. My name is Tom Nook, and I'm a Tanooki. Go figure. And I'm the founder and president of Nook Inc. Yes, yes. Today is the first day of your new life on this pristine, lovely island called Tanooki Island. Fun fact. So congratulations. It's definitely not named after my species. No, it is. It totally is. And this is a package deal, hmm? As such, Nook Inc. staff will always be here to support you and ensure your comfort and safety. But, first things first, yes, yes. I'd like each of you to choose a spot of your own. It's the first step to putting down some real roots. And I'd like you to dream big. I do have certain connections in construction and real estate, and... but I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's just get started with a simple tent, shall we? Please collect your tent from Timmy or Tommy, and then choose a spot to place it. Dude, Tom Nook has really... You know, he came from grassroots, man. He came from grassroots back in Animal Crossing on the GameCube. In Nook's cranny. You've come a long way, Nook buddy. You come a long way. Alright, here, can I have my tent? Thanks, Timmy. That's my dad's name. My dad's name is Timmy. You'll get a chance to see what it looks like before making your final decision. And you'll want a little breathing room, so take your time finding space that works for you. Oh, I suppose I should probably set you up with a map, too. Yeah, so I know where I'm going. Once you put up your tent, please find your way back here. Use your new map if you need it. Well, off you go. Hope you find a great spot. Dude, let's go camping. Dude, I really actually, like, IRL, I want to go camping, man. I'm telling you right now. I want these wood. Give me the wood. Give me the wood. Wow, damn, dude. It's so... Look at the wind. I just want to, like, I just want to take this in, man. I just want to take it all in. Just take a deep breath, dude. Like, I almost feel like I should have a fan on my desk blowing at me so that I can get the full Animal Crossing experience. Okay, so I can't do anything or interact with anything right now. I can collect apples, but I actually can't even... It looks like it won't even let me pick anything up until I've placed my tent. Or am I crazy? Well, let's go find a place to put my tent. My ultimate goal... Wait, can I cross over? Hold on. Does it matter where I put my tent now? I can put my house in a different spot, right? Nook, tell him... Don't scare me, Nook. Are you worried about finding just the right spot? Yes! Don't be. For now, choose a spot that speaks to you. Trust your instincts. It has always worked for me. Yes, yes. And down the road, if you feel you've made a mistake, we can talk about relocating. Hmm? Okay, okay. Thank you for curing my anxiety. Thank you for curing my anxiety. Hold on. Sprocket's got something to say. Yo, I'm Sprocket. You're Jepson, right? Nice to meet you, Zort. So, find a good place for a tent. I'm looking for a pitch to... I'm looking to pitch mine somewhere close to nature so I can drain my body and my soul. Sir? You're a robot. You have neither. Oh, that's cute that he thinks he has a body and a soul, though. We won't tell him. We'll let him believe whatever he wants. I'm gonna set up my tent on the beach right frickin' now. Like, right next to the beach. Just for now. I'm gonna put my house up in the top left corner eventually, though. Yes, put my tent here. Let me imagine it. Ooh. this give me a visualization? Close your eyes, visualize where the tent goes. Yeah, this is a good spot. For now. Just for now. I don't know exactly what I want to do yet, so we're not, I'm not committing to anything crazy just yet. We're going to just start and see where it goes, man. We're going to drop ourselves into this. One of the things I love about Animal Crossing and other games like this is that it's basically a sandbox that you get to drop into and just play around in. And Animal Crossing especially is a sandbox in which you collect little pieces of the sandbox as you play in the sandbox. And so it's this is going to be an endless series, essentially. I'm committing to a full year of playing through this game here on YouTube and on Twitch. And to give you an idea of how I want to structure this series, I want to cut it up in such a way that sort of tells a daily story of something. Either a story or like trying out something new or building something or creating a piece of furniture or creating a design or maybe making a town tune or talking to animals and doing some errands. And, you know, each episode is going to have a goal in mind. Right. And so for this first episode, of course, there's no goal because, we're just starting, y'all. We're just starting, y'all. OK, let's hang on. I placed my tent. Let's go talk to Nook again. Ah, Jepson, you must have found a suitable spot for your tent. Hmm. You're the first one back, so I suppose the others must still be searching for the right location. You know, since you've already done some scouting, the others might appreciate your assistance. Yes, yes. OK. Well, I want the town to be generally, like, here, so... Are you thinking about doing your thing here? Still trying to find the perfect spot. I'll be doing some serious cardio, so it's gotta have lots of fresh air. I think this spot will do the trick, but I don't know. What do you think, Jepson? I'll find your spot. What? You'll help me find a sweet spot to put this tent? Seriously? Wow! Well, we just met, and you're already doing some heavy lifting on our friendship, Jepson. Okay, then. Can't wait to see the epic spot you pick for me. Dude, I love Sprocket! He's so kind! He's like, dude, bro, just, like, let me help you. Or that's me. That's me talking to him. Dude, bro, let me help you. Well, I got you, my robot bro. Yo, okay. Yeah, dude, I'm visualizing how awesome Island Life is gonna be, too. I'm gonna put you right up next to... You're gonna be my neighbor, dude. You're gonna be my goddamn neighbor. He's gonna live right next door. I'm gonna put him. He'll be like right here. Sprocket's tent. Yeah, put it there. Let me imagine it. Can I imagine it? Oh yeah, look at that. That's a great looking tent. Yeah, I like it. All right, Sprocket, you got a new place to live, dude. My buddy, he's my best friend now. I'm just saying, he's my best friend. I don't know about Sylvie yet. I have not talked to her much. I don't know her very well. So wait, hold on. Am I not capable of picking anything up at this stage, or am I? All right, let's find. Where's Sylvia at? Sylvia, what are you thinking? What are you thinking, Sylvia? You know it. I found you a spot. Yeah, that's exactly what I was wondering. Yeah, I'll go ask her. Where is she at? Yo, Sylvia. Yo, girl. Yo, girl, I'll help you find a tent. A spot for your tent. I'm Sylvia. Gotta tell you, I'm excited to do this whole island thing. Boing. Okay, so... I was having trouble because every spot feels like the best one. I couldn't just sit here thinking it over, so I grabbed a stick and threw it. And here's where it landed. Yeah, and then it grew into a tree, I guess. Okay, so let me find you a spot. I love how in shock they are. You're gonna do it for me? It is my show now. Welcome to Good Morning Tanooki Town. Dude, I'm so excited for this. This is going to be a great year of streams and YouTube videos. Because, you know, with Banjo Buildy, which if you guys have not seen it, please check it out. There's another episode coming out tomorrow, Sunday. And I say tomorrow. I record these episodes one day in advance is basically how this is going to work. And then it will release the following day. And so, of course, today is Friday, March 20th. And we're going to be releasing this on Saturday morning. And then right after this video, a few hours after this video goes live, I'm going to be doing a live stream over on Twitch. So check out the link in the description because you might be able to catch the stream if you're watching it early. I hear you volunteer to help Sylvia set up her tent. By all means, carry on and then meet me back here when you're done, hmm? I want to put all the tents kind of like near each other-ish. So we're just going to like, we're going to put it just like one more down. I want to give enough space. Here, we're going to put it right here. I know there's a tree there, but it won't be. No. I need to rethink that crap. We're going to go one down, right here. Build here. Yeah. No, wait, that might be a little too far that way. There we go. That's a little bit more on par with the other ones. I've always liked the idea of all of the buildings sort of being in one place. So my thought is I'm going to build like a downtown Tanooki town. And it'll have like, there'll be like the residential area. And then there's going to be like the shops area. And then I'm going to have my house like out in the wilderness somewhere. I want to build like a little grove for my house with like a little pond and some trees circling the pond and sort of make it far away from everybody. Practice social distancing. Welcome back, everyone. I hope you all found just the right spots to set up your new homes. Of course, you can sleep on it for a while, Really get a feel for how it suits you. And with that taken care of, we can move on to more serious business, like throwing an island warming party. We'll have it right here in the plaza with a roaring campfire. We'll just need a few supplies to get started. Since we'll all be living here together, this will be a good test of our teamwork. Let's see. Timmy, Sylvia, Tommy, and Sprocket can set up things here in the plaza. Meanwhile, Jepson and I will work on gathering firewood and perhaps a little snack. Ooh. Pizza. Pizza, Tom. And I'm telling you, pizza will change your life. If you've not had a good pizza in a while, it's time. It's time to have a good pizza. 10 tree branches should do the trick. I'll investigate the apple-like items growing in the trees. You mean apples? God damn it, Nook. Any tree branches you find on the ground or shake out of the trees will work just fine for the campfire. Cool. I want apples, too. I want apples. So, if y'all need apples in your town, just you let me know. I'll get you some apples. This is incredible. What a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful place. Like, it makes me just want to escape here all the time. Ooh, I got a weed! Dude, I'm gonna sell some weed. You know I'm gonna. This is a Josh Jepson video. Like, yeah, we're gonna be calm and relaxed. And have a good time and you know, have a daily relaxing session of Animal Crossing. But also, I'm hoping to make you laugh a little bit, too. So, of course, I'm going to sell some weed. Oh, look, I want to catch a butterfly, but I can't because I don't got that. All right, how many branches do I got? 5. Ooh, there's one. Oops, I keep pushing X to pick up stuff instead of Y. Who knows why? Get it? Because I got to push Y instead of X. Ha! Clever. All right, I think that might be 10. Nope, that's 9. I can count. Ah, there's one. Aha. All right, Nook. I got your campfire. I did. I love how they're starting you off as, like, a forager. Like, you're not even able to get... you don't even get tools right away to go chop down a tree to get wood. You're like, no, just go pick it up, dude. And I like that, actually. Dude, here's the thing. One of the things I love about this is that it kind of feels like camping. Like, it feels like I've been kind of... you can ask my wife, Brooke. She will say that I've been talking about wanting to go camping for months now. And I think we're going to end up doing it this summer at some point. I haven't been camping in so long. And This is really scratching that itch right now, man. I'm telling you. Oh, yeah. I collected a bunch of apples, dude. They're 100% without a doubt genuine apples. I might already have six. Yes, I've already done it. Yes. Because I'm a thoughtful human being. I actually got those apples for myself, but I guess I'll share. Now, is that everything? Yes, yes, I believe it is. Let's get started with the festivities. We've invented fire! Yes! We've moved into the age of fire, everyone. We're moving up in the world. At last, allow me to properly welcome you to our new island. I have participated in many ventures and endeavors over the years, but this may be the most exciting. Same, actually. Helping develop a thriving new community entirely from scratch will truly test my business acumen. And perhaps my skills as an outdoorsman. Now, we may not have the kind of numbers that I originally envisioned, but that just means we'll have to rise to the challenge. And I have no doubt that with hard work and perseverance, we'll shape this deserted island into... I suppose we can't call this a deserted island anymore, But what should we call it? Ah! It's town name time. It's town name time. It's time to call it town. Town. Tanooki Town. Tanooki Town. Dude, I'm just really excited about Tanooki Town. I feel like it's a great name. When I said that I wanted to make the name Tanooki Town, I wanted something cute and memorable. Something that people associate with like fun and laughter and good times and happiness, and Tanooki is just really fun to say. So in the spirit of democracy, we should put it to a vote. Majority rules, So take a little time to think, and when everyone is ready, I'll present your ideas. Suggest a name for the island. Suggest a name for the island. Hopefully they just pick my name. Look, there's not a vote here. Look, I'm the only vote that matters. It's Tanooki Town is the name of the island. So we're just gonna call it Tanooki. And that's it. Tanooki. Welcome to Tanooki. The deeper lore of the series is that the actual island is named Tanooki with a U, but the town itself is called Tanooki with the O's, and I think that's fun to look at and fun to say. So here we go. I'm good with Tanooki. Don't include personal info or offensive words. Good. Alright, is everyone ready? Let's try saying our ideas all at the same time. Okay, here we go. Ready? Tanooki! Tanooki! What a splendid variety. Yes, yes. Each one a potential gem. Now for the voting. I'll say each name in order, and you can clap for the one you think is the best. Jepson seems to have the enthusiasm and the naming ability, the naming sensibilities. Let's start there. So Jepson suggested Tanooki. That's an overwhelmingly positive response. Each and every one of you clapped. I suppose everyone is in agreement. We could just go with Tanooki. Sounds good. Absolutely. Yes. I win. I told you. My vote is the only one that matters. Here I am, God. Here I am the word. Here I am the final law. I hereby name you the resident representative of Tanooki. Yay! Thank you. Golf clap now. Golf clap. Could you please say a word or two as the new spokesperson? Public speaking? Oh my god, that's what I would say. Like, I would say that. Could you say a word or two? A word or two! It's been a big day, but it's got rather late, so let's have a toast. Aw, dude, what if they actually pulled out like a slice of toast. Everyone have a beverage in hand? Oh my god, is it...
alcoholic?
It's fresh juice made from apples.
Fermented apples.
Our new resident representative harvested on this very island. Then, without further ado, I'll toast to Tanooki and the happiness of its residents. Cheers! Good morning, Tanooki Town. I mean, it's nighttime now. Good night, Tanooki Town. But good morning eventually at some point. It looks like the day is just going by on its own here. Dude, I'm jamming. Sitting around a campfire with cups of apple juice. It almost feels like we're family. You can call me bro. Okay, sure, I'll call you bro. I just don't like the word bro that much. It's like, it's kind of like, ugh, bro. Like, it's too bro-y for me. Don't be bro-y, Sprocket. Be a robot. Be a bro-bot! I know this is all a bit much, so if you feel like taking a short nap in your tent, by all means, go ahead. We'll keep the fire burning. I'm not tired yet. Dude, I want to talk to everybody. Look, I want to party hardy, man. Just stop by and see me for a quick chat before you turn in. I'll have something to give you. Okay. I look forward to it. You want some weeds? You want some weeds, Sylvia? Maybe not in front of the kid. A party around a campfire on this deserted island? Wow, now this rocks. Now this rocks. I gotta make sure that I got the right inflection there. Timmy, tell me how you feel. That's all right. We'll build a great city for everybody to live in and have a good time in. Hopefully y'all get to visit the town one day. I want you guys to go down to the comment section. What is the name that you called your town? What did you call your town? I'm kind of curious. What a great name. It just rolls off the tongue. Thank you for offering such a wonderful idea to the group. Aw, thanks, Timmy. All right, Tom, I'm starting to get a little sleepy. I think, you know, it's been a long day of picking tents and naming towns. I think it might be time to head to sleep. My very own camping cot. Whoa, a place to sleep so I don't have to sleep on the floor. Thanks, dude. All expenses paid trip, huh? At least I get a cot, free of charge. Dude, no, I'm all about this camping trip right now, I'm telling you. We'll get another big day tomorrow. Sweet dreams to you, Tom Nook. Sweet dreams to you. Can I even go inside the tent yet? Excuse me, we're setting up resident services facility in there, but it's not ready for you just yet. All right. If I must wait, I will wait. Good night to one and all. It is time to turn in for the first night, but not really. The unofficial first night, the tutorial night. Oh my god, I got a pink radio. Let's go, dude. Is that what they gave me? Oh wait, no, they gave me the lamp too. Oh, I'm guessing they must just have been facetious earlier with that question, and you actually get all of the above. Here. No room. Excuse me, sir. God, all the animations and the sounds are so perfect, too. I'm loving this. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. All right, y'all. It's bedtime. Time to turn in. Rest my head for a little while? Yes, please. Getting very sleepy. I'm gonna use this opportunity to drink some coffee in my sleep. Cold, cold coffee. KK! Oh my god, I'm freaking out, dude. Get out there, explore new frontiers. That's all the way right, daddy-o. You don't need to live by anyone's rules but your own, man. The world was made for exploring, you know? Living free, being out there, it's a great feeling. Yeah, but take it from a cat who's been on the road. being your lonesome, being by your lonesome can grind on the soul. You've got to make friends along the way. Rambling in this crazy world is Squaresville without some pals. Yeah, man, friends are where it's at. Speaking of rambling, I'm doing a bit of that myself. My bad. No, KK. Please, by all means, talk on in your sultry voice, you. Maybe it's about time for you to wake up to your new life. Ah, but listen up. That rap I just gave you about friends, that's pretty key. You'll dig this island life a whole lot more if you share it with some friends. If that's your scene. Yeah, man. An island paradise with your best pals sounds pretty groovy to me. Cool. When you wake up, you'll be in sync with real time. Dig that island life, and I'll catch you later. And there we have it. Oh my god. KK, oh, I can't wait. I hope he shows up, like, soonish in the game. He won't show up for a long time until deep into the game. I know he will. He tends to do that these days. Yes. Oh, yeah. No. You're good. I'm still napping, but I'll be decent in a moment. I slept entirely in my clothes, though, so actually I'm fine. All right. Let's go. Wait, do I get music to start with? I must. I didn't even try the radio. Hey, I've got mail. I hope you had a pleasant nap. Or, well, I suppose it was a bit more than a nap, wasn't it? It's a brand new day. Wait, I slept that long? Whoa. I mean, it was all night, so it's not really that long, I guess. It's quite normal to be worn out from such a long trip and a major life event. Speaking of which, I have a few more things that I might find useful as you adjust to life in our little paradise. First, you'll need one of these, yes? Oh my god. This dude just gave me a free phone. A free phone. Okay, but can we just talk about the fact that the Nook phone has cases that are interchangeable in the game? Good. Looks like you're getting good reception as well. Okay, feel free to put it away now. And don't take it out again in social situations, you young man, you. Stop playing that Fortnite. Put that phone away. Say, Jepson, have you ever used a smartphone before? Sure have. Very good. And this should be a breeze for you. In fact, these Nook phones are rather easier to operate than ordinary phones. Oh, yes. We simply removed most of the features. Oh. I have one more thing for you. It's your itemized bill. Oh. See, I asked at the counter, I said very specifically, are there hidden fees to this all expenses paid trip? I guess I didn't pay for it beforehand, and now I'm paying for it now. This is the all expenses. But wait, I'm poor. But wait, you're charging me for the phone you just gave me for free? 49,000 bells. I'm gonna be crippling debt. Okay. Yes. Well then. Wait. You don't have any bells. I can't believe I didn't think of this. Of course. Well, no need to worry. I was prepared exactly for this type of tricky situation. For the getaway package, you can pay your fees with miles instead of standard bells. I call this extremely helpful service the Nook Mileage Program. Wait, what? It's quite extraordinary if I do say so myself. With the Nook Mileage Program, you can earn miles by simply living your life here on Tanooki. I dare say, the more you enjoy your island life, the more Nook miles you can earn. And you can use them to pay back your move-in fees and much, much more. So the bottom line is, you'd need 49,800 bills to pay your move-in fees, but with this new service, would you believe it? It only comes to 5,000 miles. You only have to walk, swim, jump, and fly 5,000 miles. You dig fossils, eat fruit, do errands for animals, Go to deserted islands, catch bugs, catch fish for 5,000 miles. Yes, but there are more details available within your Nook phone. Just open the Nook Miles app, and you'll see that you've earned some miles by traveling to the island, joining the program. Hell yeah, dude. So we get some mileage points, and that's... So I know that there's some, like, specific features that you unlock throughout the game by completing the Nook Miles stuff. So the Nook Miles essentially becomes your single-player experience of complete these things, get achievements for them, the little, like, things on the screen. It's like, yo, you did it! And then you get rewarded for that thing! And so it's gonna be just this endless experience of fun and errands and selling things. We're gonna manage the local economy here on Tanooki Island in hopes of getting some cool furniture to decorate the island with. That's my goal. But let me heartily congratulate you once again on your arrival. I'm so happy to have you as a resident of Tanooki and a client of Nook Inc. Thanks, dude. Thanks for introducing me to the island and teaching me all the ins and outs. My new life is underway. I can do whatever I want. Well, what I would like is for to say thank you for everything. Thank you so much for watching the episode. Thank you so much for supporting on patreon.com/Jepson. Thank you so much for believing in this channel and in this series. And I hope to entertain you for the better part of the next year. Hopefully even longer. So thank you so much for giving this series a try. I look forward to the first full, proper, real day tomorrow morning, 7 a.m. Pacific time. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.